let's have some fun. This beat is sick. I wanna take a ride in your disco stick. I wanna take a ride on your disco stick. Don't think too much, just bust that dick. I wanna take a ride on your disco stick.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, car fans of all ages, welcome to the seventh installment of FvH Heatwave. I am Timmy Dangerously. Thank you for joining us on what this is, the next to last Heatwave. We only have one more Heatwave left in the season. But tonight it's all about the Vixens, and here's the queen of the Vixens right now, the brand new Vixens champion, and the leader of Fatal 4-Play, Emma Frost, making her way down to the ring. Still, no doubt, gloating about her win at Vandemonium in that six-pack challenge, where she survived five other females to hold the belt she has right now. But tonight, she most likely will be paying attention to this night, because the final two spots for the Six Vixen Rumble will be filled tonight. And one of them could involve her own. You heard the matches from the commissioner himself on the last episode of Showtime. We will run them down. But first, let's hear from the new Vixens champ. Already, she quickly making a challenge. And look who's about to step up. The former Vixens champion, Mystique. The longest reigning Vixens champ. Looking like she got a few words to say to the new champion. No doubt about it, it was Emma Frost that actually pinned Mystique in that match, on her way to winning the Vixens title. Let's see what Mystique's got to say. She is... As she did. Oh, wow. Oh wow, you talk about trying to buy your competition. Not only Emma Frost was declined an offer by Mystique to join Fatal 4-Play, but now Mystique is cashing in a rematch clause in Orlando. So now we have ourselves not only a 30-man battle room, but we have ourselves a title match. Emma Frost will have to put the strap on the line against Mystique. But tonight, the final two spots for the Six Vixen Rumble will be filled. But who will grab them? Will it be Fatal 4-Way Zone, Gina Carano, or will it be Black Cat? And in the second match, this is personal. These two have been in each other's throats for quite a while. Princess Allura and Elle Driver will go one-on-one on Heatwave.
Sometimes peaking light. Drown yourselves in mix of volume. Drown yourselves in the sound. Turn it up to match your voyage. Tendrous drifting. Lemon takes you on a ride. The ride of your life. Yeah, I wanna ride. The ride.
We are back on Heatwave, and it's now time for one of the two matches we have tonight. Both matches are qualifiers for the Six Vixen Rumble at Total Elimination. By the end of the night, we will know the five that have made it. We will know about the sixth person on the next episode of Throwdown, which in fact is our 2-year anniversary episode, where all champions will be in action. We will get to that later on, but right now, here comes Fatal 4-Play Zone, Gina Carano. This is what I was talking about earlier. What would happen if Gina ends up advancing and then winning the Six Vixen Rumble? And Emma Frost successfully retaining her title against Mystique, which she will be putting on the line at Total Elimination. What conflict of interest there? But not to look over ahead. Hopefully that's what Gina's not doing, because she had to get past this female to get to Orlando. Black Cat has had an opportunity at the Vixens title once. She would love to get another shot. She was the lead vote getter in the six pack challenge at Vandemonium, but if I'm not mistaken, she was, I think, the second person eliminated. And she was actually the first of many pinned by Emma Frost on her way of becoming the new Vixens champ. So no doubt about it, Cat wants another shot. But to do that, she has to get past the queen of MMA to do